end of all of this, we could have said, it is well. It is well with my soul. We pray this. Come on, everybody, help me in the name of Jesus. Help me. In the name of Jesus. Oh, come on, one more time.
In the name of Jesus.
I'm going to scare the devil out of this place. One more time.
In the name of Jesus.
Pray. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
If I'm gonna go to hell, right?
You won't go first class.
Might as well buy my wife
VIP.
Look at all the ladies. Yeah. Look at all the ladies. Yeah, go to hell. Let's get that shit. I just believe that when you're happy, you ought to just be happy in Jesus. And so I'm going to spend a little time talking about Adventism. Don't get mad. If you're mad, then I'm talking about you. But I also believe in the saving power of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
That no matter where you are in the depth of hell, no matter where you are in the depths of hell, God can save you.
Amen.
So I know that we prayed already, but do you mind if I just ask the Holy Spirit to jump in this thing some more?
Yes.
God, send your Holy Spirit just a little bit, so that, and hide me behind the cross. And when I say behind the cross, Jesus, you know what I'm talking about, way back there somewhere, so that only you'll be seen. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
One of the biggest mistakes that I've made, and that camera picking up my crush shirt, my crush. I told my wife I should have ironed this thing on the Sabbath, but she wanted an Adventist, you know what I mean? Is this all crushed up and all that? Look at that. If you came to see what I had on today, then you came for the wrong reason. To spread the word with you. One of the biggest mistakes I made, I wouldn't say mistakes, but I'm using it in that form, is that I decided that I was going to read Steps to Christ again. And while I'm reading through Steps to Christ, I said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to turn this into an audio book so that everybody can have it. So everybody can get it. And even though it's already out there, there's a couple of belief systems that I have. I don't care what you think. There are a couple of belief systems that I have, and one of the belief systems that I have is that all of our elementary schools, our children should be going there tuition free. Oh no, that's a big deal. Yeah, you say whatever you want to say. I'm not running for any office.
Good.
I believe that our children need to be educated of God.
Yes.
And if we take care of them, we get rid of the riffraff teachers, we get rid of all of these roads, and then do it the way it needs to be, then youth ministry would be a whole lot different.
Yes.
I just want you to get where I'm going, why I'm going through this. And so really, it's a cheap, you know, advertisement to say, it's called getstepstochrist.com, and all that money is going to Christian education.
Amen.
Getstepstochrist.com.
Amen.
Listen carefully when I say this. I do believe that, because as I do youth ministries, I realize that the foundation has been broken over the years. It's no longer the way it used to be. And it's no longer the way it used to be, because it's our fault that it's no longer the way it used to be. I'm going to say what I got to say. I want you to be able to understand that if you don't start with the children and kicking our children's behind, then there's no way that we're going to get to where we're getting to without proper discipline. I know what I'm talking about. I can see it right in the building. You let your children do whatever. You let them wear whatever they want to wear. You let them just whatever it is. It's right in the building. And if anybody says anything to your kids, you mad at them. And you don't want to come back to church anymore. Yeah. Our children are growing up like the world, and it needs to stop somewhere. Yeah, I can say that now. I can say that now, but my children 21, 22, 20, and 18, the last one is a girl, Lord. Well, you laugh. You know, I do a whole lot of, and no more, because I'm telling you, yeah, you saw it, but your kids would drive you crazy. Anybody want to know what it's like? You planning on, young people, you want to go ahead and have kids? Stay at my house. You don't need condoms, you don't need nothing after that. You just be like, I ain't doing it. That's just the bottom line. And God got a funny way of, this is the camera guy, not the back, not the back. We gotta have this way of building back our foundation. Come on, say it to me a little bit. Building back our foundation, and it does not start with the youth, it starts with our children. Say something else, you won't be upset about it, but okay. Another thing is that we should not be renting. I'm just gonna say what I gotta say. Remember, anybody get mad, just put money in the offering plate. This is for the pastor, tell him to shut up. $2,000 to shut up, I should. But I'm gonna tell you right now, we build stuff for other people, it is time. For us to build a 3,000, 4,000, 5,000
yes!
A place that we can go to that we're not paying rent because it belongs to us.
Amen! Praise the Lord. Speak the truth.
But if I ask anybody for 20